Hello everyone. Welcome on your YouTube channel of Lalbagh Girls Inter College. This is Jyoti Singh, Class 10. In your previous lecture, you have learned about the transportation in human beings, in which we have started with the blood, and you have seen that the blood have a various components. One is the plasma component and second is its cellular component, in which we have seen there are three type of cells are found in blood. One is RBCs, WBCs and platelets. We have already discussed about the RBCs. Now in this part we will see about the WBCs and platelets. So let's learn about the cellular component of blood.
Now let me tell you about WBCs. WBCs or white blood cells are also called as leukocytes. An adult human has about between 4,500 and 10,000 white blood cells per cubic millimeter of blood. The WBCs have a nucleus and are colorless. As you have seen in the RBCs, they are basically red in color due to the presence of hemoglobin pigment. But white blood cells are devoid of color. That means they are colorless, but they bear a nucleus. Here you can see a nucleus present dark blue color in the center. The WBCs provide immunity against diseases. WBCs defend the body against infection with the help of antibodies. Antibodies are Y-shaped proteins produced by lymphocytes against specific germs. Here you can see the picture, Y-shaped antibodies. They protect the bodies from the germs. Germs are basically what? They are the pathogens. Here you can see they are attached on the antibody sites. Now where we can divide white blood cells into two types. First is the granulocytes and second is the agranulocyte. The first one, granulocytes are basically granular, that means they bear granule, and agranulocyte means they do not have any granules. That is why called agranular, or we can say non-granular WBCs. Granulocytes are of three types, eosinophils, basophils and neutrophils, whereas agranulocytes are of two types, lymphocytes and monocytes. There are the two major categories of the WBCs. Non-granular lymphocytes and monocytes, and granulars are your basophils, eosinophils and neutrophils. Here you can see these are the basic structures of different type of cells. Here you can see in the center the nucleus is a different shape. Here you can see the nucleus with two lobe, three lobe structure, horseshoe shaped structure, moon shaped structure and a circular structure. Let me now tell you about platelets. This is a third cellular component of blood. Platelets are also known as a thrombocytes. Platelets are irregular cellular components and is smaller than RBCs. Platelets release factors called thrombokinase, also called as a thromboplastin, which initiate blood clotting. So for the blood clotting, it is necessary that it bears a, or it contains a factor which is called thrombokinase. Thrombokinase, with the help of calcium, activates prothrombin present in plasma to thrombin. Here you can see the flow chart, clotting process is there. In the presence of the clotting factor, you can see prothrombin converts into thrombin, and in the presence of thrombin, fibrinogen protein converts into fibrin, which is insoluble. Then finally we get a blood clot. In this manner blood clotting occurs. Thrombin in the presence of calcium, converts insoluble fibrinogen to fibrin, and fibrin forms network and trap RBCs that form a clot. Now, lymph is another type of fluid connective